Hi guys, Tracol here. I'm just gonna do a quick update on my warrior. I know it's very early and 5.2 is not even on PTR yet or released or nothing at all really, but I've actually been trying to do some try to get some other specs, just because you're probably not gonna use shockwave anymore because it's gonna have so long cooldown. Probably it will still be good in 5s and RPG, but in 2s you're never gonna use it. 3s maybe, depend. But so then it's more of a choice with Dragon's Roar and Bladestorm, in my opinion of course. Maybe you don't think like that, but I'm gonna use Bladestorm just because I really miss having Bladestorm, and sometimes it really can really help, because if you know that you're gonna get bursted by a mage and you're gonna pop your colons as well, then you like you can't get CC'd while you have Bladestorm up, and yeah, you can get disarm, but if you're fighting a team with disarm, then you just combine it with Dive of a Sword and then you will not get disarmed. So I've been trying it now in some arenas. I don't want to release too much about it because, and by the way, please be a bit careful with this. Try not to tell too many people about this, because if too many is gonna start using it, then Blizzard is probably gonna nerf this as well. But yeah, and then I'm using Stormbolt instead, so that's what you see here. It's Arena 1, Arena 2, Arena 3 and Focus. I just have Focus just because it's easier in my opinion. And yeah, so that's pretty much just I feel like Storm, you really need to have some kind of stun, and Stormbolt really helps out sometimes, because for example, if you want the mage to blink, then you just if you're running to him and you have a shard ready, then you just cast the Stormbolt, and then he will get stunned, and then he will blink, and then you can charge after him, and because you have Warbringer, or at least as I have, he will still get the full stun effect on him. I'm also thinking about switching second wind to Enraged Regen, because Enraged Regen is getting buffed and second wind is getting nerfed. Impending Victory I'm probably never gonna use, to be honest. Just because you, first of all, you need to get the melee range, and only that, sometimes you just can't do that, so. Second wind, haven't really decided full yet, but I might use it. And Rage Regen, I might use that as well, because it is on 1 minute cooldown, and it will cost 30 rage now, and if you are enraged, oh, by the way, I'm also thinking about maybe even playing a bit Fury in the next patch. And then you're getting enraged a lot more often, or you need to get enraged more often. So then you can, then that's a lot better. And it is 20% of your health every minute. And if you think like this, Warlock have a dark bar, dark regeneration, and that heals for a decent amount, 30%, but he got 2 minute cooldown. So this actually heals for more than dark regen does, and it's on a shorter cooldown. I mean, because this will be 40% if you use it twice under 2 minutes, while a Warlock can only use his once, and that's 30%. Even if it increases his healing taken as well. But if you're not playing with someone that can heal, if you're not playing with a healer or someone that can off-heal, then that doesn't really help, to be honest. So this might actually come back, because I know that I really like to have this thing in Kata, but I think it will depend. In dual, second wind is probably gonna stay superior, and in twos it really depends on what the situation is. Like if you're fighting a healer DPS, then you're probably then you might just take second wind just because you're probably not gonna get down too much anyway. Oh, oops. And Enraged Regen is a bit more for when you're fighting multiple people, because second wind can't really heal you up if you're playing with in freeze and have 2 targets, or maybe even 3 targets if you're playing triple DPS. So that might be a bit better, in my opinion at least. So this is pretty much how it looks, my spec for it, and Enraged Regen might change to that. And Glyphs, haven't really decided completely, and now I also see that I don't have Blitz, I have Mortal Strike. is probably since, and also I'm doing a dueling guide at the moment, so stay tuned for that. And I'm ball rush is still pretty nice, just to get some extra rage, especially because I'm sitting in defensive stance most time, so I can get some extra rage from that. And Colossus Smash is also very nice. Death from my bow is gonna stay for sure, and rage speed. I'm thinking about this one, how good this can be for Fury, because it feels at least like I haven't really played Fury in a pretty long time, or not focused on it that much. Just played sometimes for fun and don't really focus on what I'm doing. But it feels like they get enraged a lot more often, and then this might be very good to have. And yeah, gag order still don't work in PvP. Hamstring, nah, not needed in my opinion. This is for prot. Hindering strikes might be good, but it feels like... By the way, if any of you play Fury Warrior, can you please tell me, like, I don't even know, are you sitting, are you like, oh, so you're sitting in defensive stance most of the time, or are you going, or are you in battle stance? Because I'm not completely sure about that. Mortar strike is still nice, because at least what it seems, it increases the heal from second wind as well, and you have it up pretty much all the time. So I really like that glyph at the moment, but it's more for duels in my opinion. Yeah, maybe arena as well, but for biggies I wouldn't recommend it. Overpower, this might be good. Like, if you're using hindering strikes, then it might be good, because if you use cleave you slow all the targets that you hit. But I just can't really have cleave on my bar. I might actually replace to have a cleave instead of heroic strike, because heroic strike is gonna be pretty shit now when Taste for Blood is completely changed. Rude Interruption is decent as well. Shear Wall could be good, but you will have it in a 7-minute cooldown and all things that that people can use in arena. Got less, have the highest 5-minute cooldown, and that's what Shield Wall is on normally, so I will not take this one. Maybe for prot, but not otherwise. Spell Reflect, in my opinion, not, no, but it depends on how much you're using it. Sundering Armor, if Warrior's gonna use Sundering Armor more now, more in this patch, then this might be good. Just because most people are sitting in defensive stance anyway. So then you can just use this because you won't lose any rage by doing it. Not really this either. I don't even understand why this is in the game, to be honest. Recklessness. Depends if you want to have a bit longer burst, but the thing is that Skull Banner... sorry. Skull Banner got pretty much the same duration as Recklessness, and then you don't really need this glyph just because of that. Don't need this, not need this. I've seen some people with unending rage actually, but doesn't feel like it's that great, to be honest. But the thing that I wanted to say is that I'm gonna use Warbringer in the next patch, because it's getting a slight buff as well. I'll use Staggering Shout for sure, Safeguard, and then the other three, Second Wind, Blade Storm, and Stormbolt. Those can change. Depends if Blizzard is gonna nerf it, but hopefully not. But yeah, we will see. And really hope you enjoyed this. And I'm probably gonna talk a bit on my Shaman and my Druid as well. Bye guys.